you know, clearing up the boat, getting it, dare I say, ship shape and Bristol fashion. Dare I say that?
Yes.
Yeah.
It's small steps. Yeah.
Trying to get prepped up for a little, sort of car boot sale type thing tomorrow. We're having they call it a boat jumble sale up by the reception at the marina, which is where we are right now. So we're just popping up to the shed where we've got a load of marvellous things for sale. Some people call it our rubbish, but just have a look to see what we're going to put out to sell.
Well, now, everything in this van, in this shed, we got out of our big van, or our small van, or our boat. And this is not all of it, so it just shows how much stuff we've got. The biggest items we've got in here, this one is the smallest awning. We used it in Spain, it's very good. And at the back there's an even bigger awning we had when we had the Comanche. And we've only used it once with this van.
You can't actually see the big awning at
no,
the back, but just there is the windbreaks, the Jorvik windbreaks.
That would keep the dog in, and they've got a gate on them, haven't they?
So, and that in the black plastic there is the top bed for the current van.
Yes.
And then we've got a washing machine, a portable washing machine that we, you know, we don't think we're going to use because we didn't use it much before. And we've got these fans that we've had for the boat in the summer, didn't we?
Yeah. But we don't seem to spend the summer in the boat because we usually go to Europe for the summer, so we don't need them.
Well, our plan is that it'll be Spain in the winter, UK, and then Sweden. So, and then UK, and then Spain in the winter again. So that'll be 6 months in Europe, 6 months in Spain, 6 months in the UK.
Thing is, we're paying out quite a lot in rent for this shed.
It's £540 a year.
Yes. And I don't think if we sold everything, we would get that. And also, there's only one or two things that we really, really need to keep. Forever things, so, and I would say that is about a quarter of the things in this shed are things we're going to keep long term.
This travel suitcase is full of photographs.
Yes,
isn't it?
It is photographs. So journals. I can't. I've
photographs and journals and things, sort of memories.
Yes, memories
written down. Yeah. The box at the back has crochet stuff, maybe some arty stuff, and some jigsaw
maybe we
puzzles.
Don't, yeah, we probably don't need all that.
We've had a bit of a recce of what's happening in the shed. Because we're going to be selling stuff tomorrow, Wendy thinks that we need to go and get some change. So we're going to go, we're going to walk to the post office and change up a 20 pound note or something. As part of our decluttering, we are having to really, really get down to it. And you know how they say it's the darkest before the dawn. Well, it certainly feels like it's just before dawn right now. We've got so much stuff just hanging around, and we don't really, you know, we just haven't got that pick it up, decide it, get rid of it, or charity, or sell. We just haven't got that down to an art yet. I'm standing here in the boat stern deck, so the narrow boat is a cruiser style, so we've got quite a large space at the back. we've had this cover fitted, which all folds down for the summer weather, but it creates a really nice space for the winter. And we're starting to sort of use it as we clear stuff out and declutter the boat. We're starting to use this as a bit of a dumping ground, which is a complete nightmare. We shouldn't be doing it, but we've got a plan today to clear everything out of here, put it out on the on the bank there, and then make decisions about what we're going to do. So I've got all sorts of stuff out here. Look, you know, I've been doing a bit of sanding in various places, so I've got my sander. Once I've finished sanding, and I only really need that for little bits of the boat, just to smooth over things, maybe a couple of bits of woodwork on the inside. But once that is done, I will not need that sander. So, you know, that's either going to go for sale or it'll be given to one of my sons. So that's that. But let's just give you a bit of a view around, and I'll talk you through what we've got, what's rubbish, what I know is rubbish, and what we're not sure about. So here we go. This is the door entry into the boat. We go down some stairs there, but we've got all sorts of bits and pieces like this, old little tools and stuff for the boat. And this box used to be screwed to the inside wall there. I've got some car washing stuff, which we'll keep. Got a load of that. Paint roller. I've got a brand new set coming because I didn't take care of that. So that will go out. There is a Stirling battery-to-battery charger in that bag, which will be fitted to the boat at some point. This this is the life jacket for Pippin. I don't think we're keeping that. There's the box for the HEO safe locks. I don't know why we're keeping that. I think there's a couple of bits. No, that's rubbish. Some ball bungees. Sounds like the generation game now. A Seaflow bilge pump yet to be fitted. The bilge pump on the boat at the moment doesn't work, so I've got to fit a new one. There's some new yellow stripe for the outside of the boat. We're just sprucing it up a little bit. Some old bits of wood. Some, as I say, we've got paint, and that's for the boat. That paint's gone off. It's going in the bin. Lots of car cleaning and paintwork stuff there. This is the pontoon, and then we've got more boat paint, a drill, a tool bag. Tool bag needs to be really, really consolidated down. So I've got the tool, the sander there. There's a paint buffer, which is new, because the boat and the van need a bit of a TLC. This is a box of things for the paint buffer, so we'll be keeping that. There's that has been removed from the boat temporarily. That's got to go back in. Then there's this box of paint, a jerry can. There's a new wet vac there, which that's brand new. It's been used, obviously it's been used a few times, because we had a bit of a leakage in the boat, and we had to sort of hoover up a load of water, and while we were away we had a bit of a catastrophe, and we had to replace the floor in the kitchen, which has all been done. So that's all okay. So that's the sort of stuff that we've got out. So we're going to get everything out, and you'll have seen what a complete mess it is. You know, it really is not good at all. So we just need to sort of make sure that we're all clean and tidy there, and getting stuff. I mean, the main thing is that we get rid of everything we don't need or want, and that's the big thing for us, is that getting rid of stuff, you know, really important, because we can't go traveling anymore with all this junk. I call it junk, wonderful things that people might want. So and we've got a lot of that, so. But let's get on with doing the real work. So what you can see down here, when you're just bringing out the last bits and pieces, is all of the stuff, a mixture of sort of good stuff and stuff that we're going to sell, and complete rubbish that we're going to throw in the bin. We're going to get some black bin liners and load up the rubbish, and then sort out the wheat from the chaff, as it were. Stuff we want to sell and stuff we're going to keep. That's gonna take us a little while, but I'm gonna take you back inside just to see the clearness of the space now. So here we are, as we approach the boat. We've not completely cleaned it up, but you can see the amount of space we've got in there now with it clear. This board is usually used to sit on as you're operating the tiller, but we're gonna take that out, and we need to really clean up the floor, because it's a little bit of coal dust in. There's a little bit of sort of surface rust coming back, you know, because this is a wet space, so there's a lot of water gets in here through the gaps here. As the water runs down, it just dribbles off the edge there and comes in, and you know, you can see it's a little bit messy, a little bit mucky. So we're going to really clean all that up, but first we're going to get rid of the rubbish, aren't we, Wend?
Yeah, but there's an awful lot of stuff just from that small area.
This is something we're going to keep, isn't it? Got stuff for the air ambulance clothing bank. There's a pair of shoes, pair of boots, and an old dressing gown. There's a whole load of rubbish. Wood that we don't need. Stuff that's damaged in the flood that we had. There's stuff for the car boot sale that we've all put into a big plastic bin bag. It's all sort of little bits and pieces, and then there's a whole load of stuff that we're still keeping. So there's a dust sheet. Well, that's temporary, because we're still doing decoration inside. There's a whole box of paint. There's some tools. The step that came with the boat, of course, which has been useful while I've been navigating up and down the canals, because I'm only 5'6", so I can't see over the chimney while we're going along, so I have to stand on that step, and I think the last owners must have been like that as well. Then I've got my tools, my tool bag, I've just crammed everything in there, and that needs sorting out. There's also all the car cleaning and interior detailing stuff that we're still to use on the boat to get the boat spick and span. And then we've got a couple of bits. We've got a jerry can. I don't know if we'll keep that. I'm not sure about that. And then we've got a battery-to-battery charger that's still to be fitted to the boat. We haven't had to use it because we don't go many places and the battery lasts quite a while, so we haven't needed it. But there we are. So what a good clean out. I think we've done quite well. It is a bit of it's darkest before the dawn sort of feeling, and it does still feel like that. It really, yeah, we've cleared out all this stuff. I think we've got rid of half of what's there, but there's still loads of stuff inside the boat, particularly a load of tools that I've bought to do work on the boat, because it wasn't particularly the way we wanted it when we bought it. It's more that way now. But there you go. So decluttering continues, and on we go.